Draw the isometric position of the combination of solids formed by frustum of cone and coaxially frustum of pentagonal pyramid. So the dimension of the frustum of cone is 80 mm base diameter and 60 mm top diameter, and height is 25 mm. And the frustum of pyramid, pentagonal pyramid, base will be 30 mm and the top face is 20 mm and height is 40 mm. Okay, so first you have to draw the pentagon of the base side and the top side. So base side 30 mm, and written the pentagon and write the reference boxes will join the all the corners of the pentagon and check the dimension. Okay, so as it is same for the top pentagon 20 mm side, you have to write the reference boxes and check the dimension. Okay, so then you have to write the frustum of cone. Okay, so base diameter is 80, so we'll take the 80, enter 30 degree angle, then 80, enter 150 degree angle, 80, enter 210 degree angle, and 80, enter minus 30 degree angle. Okay, so now we can join for isocircle corner to the midpoint of opposite edges. For two edges, we have to search the midpoint. As it is same from the top corner, midpoint of the opposite side, midpoint of the opposite side. Okay. Now we can draw the tangent by arc by center point command. Draw the arc. You have to take the cursor from inside. You will get the neat curve, neat arc. Same from the intersection point, draw the arc, small arcs from the right side. You can draw it like this. Okay, finish. Then you have to take the dimension to the 60 mm. So this is 80, you need 60. Go for scale option, select the copy, then 1:1 scale. So here we need 60 mm and given circle is 80, so press enter and simply just place it, fit and place it outside. Okay, so then move it, then you can zoom again and draw the line for fine noting the midpoints. Okay. So what is the height of the cone? This is 25 is given, then go for the line from the exact midpoint. You have to take 25 90. Okay, then fit it and place, just move this one diagram from the midpoint to the end point. Okay, zoom it, I will show you your end point. Okay, then you have to draw the edges, you have to join it. So don't select this corner. Okay, you have to select any of the curve edge to the tangent edge. Okay, so select, you can do curve edge to the tangent edge on both sides like this. So curve to the tangent. Okay, now I will draw the pentagon. Above this one you have to place the pentagon, so better you can delete the inside lines. Okay, so for this point you have to place the pentagon midpoint of the pentagon. So from the left hand corner I have to start this. This is the 30 degree angle line, this is 150 degree angle line, this is again 210 degree angle line, this is minus 30 degree angle line. Like that you have to draw, you will get the end points. Easily you can draw the pentagon. Okay, so initially is 28.53 and 17.63. Okay, so I will draw this one line command. So 28.53, enter 30 degree angle, again 17.63, enter 30 degree angle. Okay, so next line is 24.27, enter 150 degree angle, again 24.27, enter 150 degree angle. Okay, so here you have to come 17.63, enter 210 degree angle. Again 28.53, enter 210 degree angle. So now we have to draw here. So what is the dimension? 9.27 here. Okay, so 9.27, fit the page, zoom it. 9.27, enter minus 30 degree angle. So side of the pentagon 30 I am taken, angle will be minus 30. Again 9.27, enter minus 30 degree. Okay, so now we have to draw the pentagon. So easily you can find out the endpoints. Check the endpoints here, you'll get the endpoint symbol, click it, and next endpoint. So you can look at the endpoints and look at the endpoint, and you can find out the endpoints here, midpoint. So here endpoint, and here also endpoint, and join to the endpoint. Okay, so next you have to find out the midpoint of the pentagon. Here also midpoint of the line. Okay, you will get the intersection. This is the midpoint of the given pentagon. So copy this one, I mean move this part, okay, directly this intersection point to the end point. End point or midpoint. Yes. Okay, this pentagon, base pentagon is over. Next top pentagon is 20 mm side. Take it, you can see the 19.02 and 11.76 and 16.18. Okay, so as it is same, I will take the line command. This is a 19.02, enter 30 degree, 11.76, enter 30 degree, 16.18, enter 150 degree, again 16.18, enter 150 degree, again 11.76, enter 210 degree, next 19.02, enter 210 degree. So here you can look at this one, 6.18. okay, so 6.18, enter minus 30 degree. Pentagon side is 20, enter minus 30 degree, again 6.18, enter minus 30 degree. Then you have to draw the isopentagon, end point to the end point to the end point, next end point, and you can draw the end point to the final end point. Okay, so now we have to find out the pentagon, midpoint of the pentagon, and can draw the corner to the midpoint of opposite edges. Okay, now to select this one, move command, choose the move command. Okay, so intersection point, fit the page and zoom it here carefully. Okay, you should not copy here because some height you have to give. What is the height is given? 40. Okay, so you have to give the height 40, means you have to take it this one 40, enter 90 degree, enter. So now we can move this one pentagon. So select it, move option, intersection symbol, select this one exactly center to the end point. Okay, this is the easy method to do this one. And after this, go for a visible part. So select this one, press control and select whatever the required lines. So select the curves, select the curve. Okay, select the edges, select the pentagon. Initially you have to select all lines, after that you have to split that one. Okay, all pentagon 5 lines. Okay, so make it 0.5. okay, so now we can look at this one. So join the edges of the pentagon directly, you will take the 0.5 thickness, edges of the pentagon, end point to the this one. Okay, if you choose the end points, easily it will be joined, otherwise very difficult to join this one. See, look at this one, this is only visible part, this both edges will be inside. Okay, so I will check the, if you want you can write you can take the thickness will be very less, 0.25 or 0.13. Take it and choose the endpoints. Okay, right. So this is the frustum of cone, and the above the frustum of cone, the pentagon is placed. Right. So you can select the whole diagram. Go for scaling. Deselect the copy. So scale is, you can open. I think it's already there. No, 0.8164. Enter. Okay, place in the same x-y line. Right. So after this, you have to go for the take the dimension first 30 degree angles on both sides. Good, and can go for the vertical dimensions. Take the smart dimension. This vertical height of the pentagon also, and also pyramid and cone. Okay, so if you want, you can take check the dimension of the